What up, y'all? It's your boy Polo Cut says D. Welcome back to another episode of Off the Clipper. I'm right here with the gang, the one and only.
Yeah, Manny. Boy, Manny Rocks.
Manny Rocks in the building,
what's up,
baby.
Everybody?
Yes, sir. Next to me, I got my wife, the one and only Tat Knees, baby. You already know what it is. Today, man, you guys, we have a dope ass guest, one of my boys, client. Fucking smart ass motherfucker, you know,
he's
entrepreneur, business owner, fucking fitness equipment technician. If you need someone to come through to your house and set up a dope ass fucking gym in your garage, in your in a room or anything like that, this is the guy to hit up. My boy Manny Anaya in the building, baby. What's up, big dog?
How are you,
man? Hell yeah. Shit, it's been some time that we've been talking about it, a couple weeks, maybe a month.
Yes, sir.
Before we get started, guys, let me remind you guys that you guys can always watch us on YouTube, and you can always listen to us on every podcast streaming platform: Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Anchor, all that stuff. Make sure you guys listen. If you don't have the time to watch, go listen to it, because any support that we get is very helpful for us. And yeah, let's get started, bro. How you doing? How's your day going? How's your week?
Oh man, it's been a long day, but I'm glad to be here.
Yeah,
I'm doing amazing, feeling good.
You just got off of work right now, like,
yeah. So
probably less than an hour ago,
about 7 o'clock.
Yeah, regular damn day. Thank you for coming, dog.
No, put it in work. Just
hell
like
yeah,
you,
hell yeah, dude. I just got done too, but thank you for coming, bro. Because yes, I mean, I've invited a lot of people that tell me like, oh dude, I'm barely getting off of work and it's like 6, and I'm like, bro, it's not till 8:30, and they're like, you know, I gotta go eat, I have an A, and I'm like, dude, like, just a little bit of OT is not gonna hurt you, you know.
Never will. Mm-hmm. You gotta put in that saying? Hard work.
Yeah, definitely. And then sometimes like that work that you don't get paid for, that shows the heart that you're putting into your brand, yourself,
that extra mile.
Yeah, that type of, exactly, that little extra mile, that mm-hmm. push is what really shows me what type of person you are. If you don't give a fuck, or if you're just like, you know.
Yeah, definitely. That's how you stand apart.
Yeah, dog. So for the people that don't know you, bro, tell them what it is that you do exactly with your business and all that. I know you have it with your dad.
Yeah, exactly. So it's a family owned and operated business. So nice. What we do is we do repair service on all fitness equipment. So any brand, any manufacturer, we do maintenance, we do repairs, we do, like I said, service. Anything that has to do with the fitness equipment, we handle. So we do assemblies, we do setups, we do relocations all over San Diego, from all the way to the border. We know we go all the way up north, Oceanside. We go into Riverside County.
Nice.
We have a couple accounts down in Brawley, El Centro. So we go
That's
east.
Right.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So we even go across the border. We go down to Baja.
Oh, damn.
We got Ensenada. So, I mean, we're just little by little, you know?
Yeah.
Ensenada's nice. We were there not too long ago, and they have a nice little downtown area.
Yeah, they have a beautiful downtown. Mm-hmm. They have a couple nice hotels, gyms. So yeah, I mean, we have a couple contacts down there that contact us every once in a while to do the full service out there and do repairs, and
nice.
Nice. Yeah. They take care of us.
That's dope, dog. Yeah. Your business, bro. I mean, I see it thrive all the time, dude. You're doing good. You're always busy.
Mm-hmm. Always.
You having long days tells me that you're fucking doing the right thing, bro.
100%. 100%.
So how did you guys get into that whole business?
So I mean, first and foremost, it started with my dad. He's the owner of the company. He had the American dream, you know.
Yeah,
he came from he's from Mexico, obviously. He's accredited down there. He got his engineering degree and all that stuff, and decided, you know, Mexico of course had the opportunities, but the U.S. is where it's at.
Yeah,
you know,
for
it
sure.
It all starts with the American dream, right?
Yes, sir.
And he came out here. He tried a couple things, and I think he had always mentioned to me, any job that he did or he was a part of, he always wanted to see if he can kind of start his own brand or start his own company, start his own wave kind of deal, right?
Yeah.
And so he actually got into doing deliveries for fitness equipment, a company, smaller company, little by little started doing deliveries, started overtaking San Diego, and then noticed that, yes, there's money in it, but it's not so much the physical labor, it's more mental. So he started learning how to fix the equipment, started becoming an actual technician instead of just delivery. He didn't want to do physical work for the rest of his life.
Yeah.
You know, he wanted to branch out and expand it. And little by little.
That's where the money's at, man, when you get technical with it.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's not about breaking your back. Like they always say, you know, you know, work smarter, not harder. And that's what exactly what he's about. So little by little, he started learning the, he's self-taught. You know, there's not a lot of things that we can, you know, go to school for. It's not a trade that's very, very common. So yeah. It's a little bit of a niche business, but little by little, he started kind of doing his own thing. And soon enough, he started getting contacts. He started, you know, creating a personal relationship with a lot of people. And, you know, he created this company that, that we're at now.
Nice, bro. Mm-hmm. Shit, that must be fucking, that must be hard, bro, to, like, so for example, I have a cousin of mine. This guy, since he was a little kid, bro, he would take computers apart and then put them back together, you know, for him to be self-taught how to fix a machine. Yeah. That shit must be hard, because I'm pretty sure he had to take everything apart and then put it back together. Yeah. And, you know, just find the problems here and there and shit like that. And
I would say it's a lot of trial and error before you really get down to it. Yeah. And, you know, you got to make sure you remember. He always told me it's not a mistake if you learn from it. It's a lesson.
Yeah.
So that's something I've always thought. You know,
I like that.
I take that from him.
Nah, yeah, that's mad respect, dude, to your dad. And then 100%. And then you know what, like, It fed you throughout the years, through your childhood and your teenage years. Now you're able to harvest out of that as well yourself.
Oh, definitely.
And then it's now feeding your family, and that's amazing, bro. For something that he made literally something from nothing.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Like he didn't fucking, like, nobody. Usually people, like, You go to get a job and then or whatever, you know, like me, I go to a school and they teach me how to fish. You know, you teach a man how to fish, he'll never starve. Exactly. You get me? He fucking literally went out there by himself and jumped into it. Yeah,
exactly.
That's hard, bro.
Yeah, man. How long has the business been going on?
So San Diego Fitness Services has been prospering for about 25 years now. So
That's what's up.
I wasn't expecting that number. Yeah,
up until years. Like I met you. Like, I didn't even know, like, that was a thing.
Right,
you know?
And that's what a lot of people tell
me. That's what I was going to say, too.
It's like, how's it, like, the competition with that? Like, is there a lot of people doing it?
So, I would say it's definitely like being a mechanic, but without the competition. Everybody needs it. Everybody needs a mechanic, and there's a million mechanics out there. Mm-hmm. But for us, it's like, there's maybe, I would say, maybe 6-7 big companies that really do it.
You know what I noticed too? Not a lot of people know that there's technicians out there for that. They just fucking, oh, my treadmill broke. All right, I'm gonna buy a new one. Yeah. Exactly. Like, they don't know. Yep. It just needs one little fucking.
Exactly. And that's something
it's like
that
a $5, $10, $15 piece, you know, you're gonna spend $3,000 to replace it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, like, definitely. So I mean, we're definitely providing a solution for a lot of people's problems.
That's crazy.
That's sick.
So it's an interesting job, because I mean, it takes us to a lot of places, a lot of different things. I mean, you got to think about it. Everybody works out.
Yeah.
Everybody works out. And like you said, when something breaks, I mean, they either replace it or repair it, but they don't know who to call. And I mean, we're the guys.
Hell yeah. You know what's crazy, bro? In the barber game, I've looked it up, bro. When I've had good chairs that are not the type of chairs that you can just throw out when they break. It's a chair that you want to fix.
Right.
And in San Diego, bro, there's not one technician for barber chairs.
I mean, there you go.
Not one.
There you go.
The nearest guy is in LA, and he literally came down here, and I asked him. I was like, "Hey, do you know of any technician out here?" He goes, "No. Every time someone needs a technician out here, they call me, or they do it themselves." And there's
light
not
bulb.
One. Yeah. Exactly. That shit is crazy.
Message.
Yeah, but
we're gonna have to capitalize on that somehow.
I mean, that, no, and
cut
then,
that out
and
then the video.
And
the
thing,
I know, right? No, but the thing is, I have a homeboy of mine. He's actually from Ensenada. He fixes barber chairs. So for the longest time, because of the pandemic, people can't cross over here if they're not U.S. citizens.
Exactly.
I was waiting for him, and he finally came by the other day. He's like, "Hey, I'm finally back." And I'm like, "Whoa, I got a couple of chairs you need to fix." He goes, "Dude, don't trip. I got you. Let me just," he's like, "I'm gonna go back over there for a couple of weeks, and then when I come back, I got you," you know? Yeah. So dude, that's fucking amazing, dog. Like, you guys need to like just keep going. And fuck, dude, I mean, you guys are doing something
it's
right. 25 years, homie.
Definitely.
That talks nothing but great things about you guys.
Yep.
And how many people do you guys have? Is it a big company already, or is it still like very like an intimate?
So that's kind of where I come in, right? I feel like his vision was kind of I wouldn't say it's almost like he's hesitant. It's his baby, right? So he doesn't want to necessarily expand and go, you know, full commercial or do anything too
pay
crazy.
Attention, guys.
But But that's where I come in as the next generation and
you know, new school.
The new school and everything that he's taught me, I'm applying it. And now it's my turn to really take over and expand it. And I have this vision of making it an enterprise. And just like how everybody, like you said, it's not a sought after trade that a lot of people can do. So we can really capitalize on that.
Yeah.
And the fact that it's high demand. I mean, think about it. Like everybody here in San Diego, where all the big gyms or let's say professional athletes or we do border patrols, we do schools. Everybody has a gym. So it's just a matter of time before we can really take over. Even though it's a family owned business, I mean, we really have a big grasp of all of San Diego and the market here in San Diego. So it's a blessing, honestly.
There's for sure a lot of opportunity and a lot of room for you guys to grow.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so, I mean, we've talked about it while I'm cutting your hair, you know, like the amount of things you could do now that I'm pretty sure your dad is very like hesitant, like you said,
right,
about doing. He might not see it or know it, but like, dude, even just like a simple thing like social media could just
expand so much.
And I'm pretty sure your dad being like an older guy, you know, and an old school person that's really not involved in social media like my parents, you know, like they don't understand back in the day.
They're more traditional, like let's not fix something that's not broken.
Exactly.
But for you, it's correct. There's a whole nother fucking, we're like Ariel right
it's
now.
It's untapped.
Like you just want to like go out there.
Exactly.
But what I was going to say is that, for example, like me with the shops, mm-hmm. I'm usually doing the one that does all the paperwork and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Dude, it's a whole nother world. Like, especially for a business, you can put so much under your belt. Like later you can have contract for maintenances. Mm-hmm. You can have like certain amount of clients. You can have your employees. Like it's never ending.
It really is. I mean, like the opportunities are endless, and I just feel like what he provided for me was, I mean, it's a golden opportunity, right? It's like you said, it's the American dream. I mean, he's an entrepreneur through and throughout, and the fact that he's able to give that to me and allow me to kind of like take reign and make those executive decisions. It's like, I mean, what more can he ask for as far as, you know, I guess an immigrant, you know,
it's crazy, no pressure.
Yeah, for real.
I mean, there is a lot of pressure, but I mean, I'm taking it, you know. He's set me up for success.
Of course.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I gotta just,
the crazy.
Does he still work?
Yeah. He still does, you know, 9 to 6, 9 to 7.
That's right.
He still puts in work, man. I mean, I'm trying to make sure he retires early, but you know, the old school Mexican.
They never. It's hard, bro. Like for someone, especially him, that it's his own business, bro. For someone that's so used to going, being taking active every day, stuff, you know, like for them to just tell you like, hey man, walk away already. Like, I got you.
Exactly.
And it's like, fuck, like,
he's like,
Mexicanos
are like,
yeah,
I'm
going to
morir. Like,
if
I stop,
yeah, bro,
that's what he says.
That's what my mom and my dad tell me, bro. Like, I'm like, well, when are you guys going to retire? You know, like, I think my mom can retire already, but she's like, it sucks to say it, but I've seen cases where people retire and then, you know, it's like, I wait. Yeah. Like,
that's scary.
You know, sometimes.
That's what used to happen to like when I used to do cement.
Mm-hmm.
Like the people that would retire, like they would die like within 5 years of retiring.
Oh fuck!
But because you're going from like hard labor
every day
for fucking 30 years or you know whatever.
That's not doing nothing,
and then you just like start shriveling up. You know, you got to keep moving when you retire. You know?
I feel like that's like their purpose. You don't to like just the fact that they. From going hard every single day to nothing, it's just like that's a drastic change for them
that's
too.
Fucking
insane.
Like I don't think they can handle that.
Yeah. Hey, so you're a first generation
Mexican
American here.
Exactly. Uh-huh.
Your dad brought you here at what age?
I was about what was it, first grade, so I was like about 4 or 5.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Do you think that has some type of effect on how hard you work now?
Oh, big time. I mean, I have that as an example every single day. I see how hard he works, how badly he wants it. I mean, to me, it's about carrying his legacy.
Yeah.
And I can't fail.
You have a big shoe to fill, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, there's no, to me, I always said, everybody was like, oh, well, what if this doesn't work out? I mean, that's not an option for me.
Yeah,
for sure. There is no plan B. For me, it's plan A, and I'm going to take it as far as I can. And I just want to make sure that everything that he sacrificed for, it comes to fruition, and it just, I want to make sure that one day he looks back and he says, wow, like, I'm everything that I did it for a reason.
Yeah.
You know what mm-hmm. I mean? That I can't let that guy down.
Yeah, no, for sure. That I ask you that question because I'm the same way, bro. Like, I got here when I was 7, mm-hmm. and I feel like that has a lot to do with the way that I work, you know, like, oh, yeah. so much, you know? Mm-hmm. I mean, at the end of the day, I could give a fuck if a person thinks of me any less than what I am or whatever, right. you know? But obviously, if my dad is, like some type of disappointment for my dad, it's like, oh, shit, yeah. like, you know? Not mm-hmm. just, I mean, obviously, there's that respect, but, mm-hmm. like, one of my boys, bro, one time, he's a first-generation Mexican-American here, and when he turned, he was, like, 19, 20. Right. He obviously got a job here, but he wasn't really, you know, like, really doing much. Like, he didn't have, like, a great job or whatever. So, he decided to move to Mexico to TJ and work over here, you know? And mm-hmm. he told his dad, and I remember his dad was like, are you fucking crazy, bro? Like, you're telling me I went through all this for the past, like, fucking 14 years. I brought you out here for you to just fucking move back to yeah. Tijuana.
Yeah.
He's like, fuck no, bro. What are you talking about, dude? He's like, I bust my ass. I work, I have my job, and then I do side jobs, and then I fucking have an extra hustle. Hell nah, dog. Like, if I was able to do it, and I didn't even speak no English, exactly. you know, how the fuck can you not do it? You speak full English, bro. Like, there's so many ways that you can like find an income here, bro. Like,
big time,
like,
a lot of people are like, you know, prideful.
Yeah.
You know, they're like, I'm too good for that.
Yeah.
You know, like the tamale guy or fucking selling the elotes.
Yeah.
Like, no one wants to do it, but I mean, that could be extra money.
Hey, but he's so nice. He's so humble.
Yeah, but see, he is humble and he's nice, bro, but he didn't, okay, he's not just, okay, so he sells elotes, but it doesn't stop there. What are they doing now? They're fucking buying more carts and renting them out. Now this was now this was like thinking outside the box, and exactly. fuck that. I need to fucking have other motherfuckers working for me
when
now.
When I was tattooing, like, one of the elote guys, they were telling me about how they have a whole fucking house full of those motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Like, they got a whole bunch. They got a Yellowstone
it's
going
like
on.
It's like a fucking, it's like a frat expanding. House.
Yeah, yeah. no, it's
for real. They all just ran out of house. Yeah. They don't,
and
you
then
know,
they're talking
divided
about
up.
The locations. Oh, Pandamos, I hit where we're gonna do this, and I'm like, damn, you guys should hit up the block.
You know what's crazy? Like,
and
we're not gonna.
And then they only work on weekends, you know?
Yeah,
and
bro. Like,
yeah, right.
And they're making bank.
They went to the beach one day and they sold out killed like it. Fucking yeah. 3 hours. Oh, I was like, what?
And you got to remember this. Look, like, these guys own their own cart and they're making all the profit is full profit, right? But like. So that's them. There's another group of guys. They all come from Mexico. They come from like Sonora and that area. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's no way we can burn them out. I'm going to say like what they do really. But dude, these guys are literally just working like in downtown illegally. Like they don't have no fucking permits, nothing they buy like 10, 12 cards, bro. And then they rent all of them out. They keep one. They're making money, bro. And then boom, they charge the other guys and they all live in a house, bro. And it's fucking
like,
insane. How like,
Coronado.
You know, or like I have another homeboy, bro. This fool's like, working all day, bro, and recently he just started fucking buying picking up pallets, bro. I don't know if you heard about that hustle, but you can actually go around and pick up pallets. The ones that have the four holes around, they pay you $8, and the ones that just have two on the sides, they pay you $6 to return them to this place in Main Street. Yep. Like, bro, they're so you don't need a fucking business license for that. You don't need nothing. You just pick them up and take them like recycle. It's like a recycle center. You know, but it's for that.
You just gotta have that motivation.
You
gotta find a way, you know?
And I, like, it's crazy because I told one of my boys and this fool, again, I'm not gonna say names, but this fool's always wearing, wearing, like, fucking brand clothes. He looks rich as fuck. And
he's broke
and he's broker than shit. Anyways, he was like, fuck.
Like, you look real fly at the bus stop, homie.
Yeah. Nah, but the thing is, it's like, this fool's like over here, like telling me how broke he is or how he's struggling. And I'm like, dog, like, bro, you have a truck, fool. And I told him, go get some pallets, fool. Go behind Walmart and Home Depot. And
that's
all
what
the Manny's
saying, the pride.
Like, yeah, and the pride is what stops him from doing
that. Can't be seen
wearing
his Gucci's picking up pallets, you know what
I mean? And it's crazy because another homeboy of mine, him and his dad, they do the same but with shopping carts. Now these fools have an actual business. Like, these fools have a huge business now. Like, it's a big ass company. These fools are hiring people. They have employees. Now these fools are fucking going picking up shopping carts for them. They have contracts with Walmart, Costco, Target, fucking all that shit, you know? And that shit just started out of nowhere. You know, when they were at their downest point of their life, they came up with the idea to go pick up shopping carts. Right now, that fucking company is worth, maybe not millions, but it soon will be
worth
that. It's worth a lot of money, you know, and it's because necessity will make you fucking,
it'll make it or break you.
Exactly, dog. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's just tough, dog. Like, especially being a business owner, bro. Like, and I'm pretty sure your dad's been doing it for 25 years in the 90s. I'm pretty sure it was a lot harder than it is now too. You know, like, we have so much, we have it so easy, bro.
Sorry.
We have it so easy, like, now compared to the way people used to have it back in the day, you know?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
How do you guys get your clients?
So, he started off by just creating a network, you know?
Like word of mouth?
Yeah, word mm-hmm. of mouth. That's mostly a lot of his contacts are just word of mouth referrals and all that stuff. But we also have a couple companies or a couple stores that sell equipment that, you know, hire us out as third-party contractors. Mm-hmm. So, shout out to them. They give us a lot of business. So anytime they sell equipment or they need service, we're either installing or doing services for them. So
That's sick.
And then we also do I can't think of the name, but right now we get accredited or certified. There you go. That's a better word. Certified for actual manufacturing companies, and then they'll contact the manufacturer, and then they'll actually refer us to them.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, yeah. So say for example, let's say you have this certain piece of equipment, you know, it's broken or something like that. You contact them directly, and they'll say, okay, who's out in San Diego that can do the service, who could do repairs, or who do you recommend? And then they'll refer us.
Oh, shit.
So, yeah, so we're certified with a lot of companies like that as well.
That's dope.
That's impressive. Mm-hmm.
You know what's crazy? Earlier she was mentioning the whole thing about equipment breaking down, and then the people just fucking sell it or let it toss it out.
That's what I do. If something breaks, I'm like, I ain't gonna fix it.
No, well, one of my boys, he actually had a treadmill, bro, and he was one day he was gonna throw it out, and I was like, what's wrong with it? He goes, I don't know, it's not working right. And I was like,
he never even tried to use it because it worked fine.
I was like, are you sure? And I was like, let me see. So he gave it to me. And I fucking plugged it in, bro, and it works.
I was like,
what the hell? That's a lot of our clients. It's really? A lot of I'm not gonna say like trophy wives or housewives, because we work a lot in North County, a lot of very well off people.
Yeah.
You know, in Sanitas, Carlsbad, Rancho, Santa Fe area. And a lot of times they're like, oh, my machine's not working, or it's not working properly, and we'll get there, you know, we'll plug in something, or we'll just turn it on and hit the light switch or something, and there it turns on. What did you do? I mean, it's working properly.
$500.
Exactly. They're like, oh, well, please don't tell my husband. No, I'm going to do a full service. I'm going to do full maintenance on machine. I'm going to tell you know, that we actually ended up fixing it and something that was needed to happen. So a lot of times it's just, yeah, like you said, they just don't use it. It ends up being like an expensive coat rack. New Year comes around.
Yeah.
And, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like New Year's resolution.
Yeah.
And so they call us out and it's not working. It's not, we plug it in, everything's good. You know, we do the full service. You know, I don't ever half-ass anything as well. Like, even if it's just, you know, it doesn't turn on and it turns on right away, we still do a full service and make sure, you know, they're getting their money's worth. Yeah. I never want to just walk away and say, okay, I just turned it on and it was good to go.
Like, oh, but it works. All right, bye.
Exactly, bro.
I'll pay you later.
Sure, you know, that they're getting their money's worth, because, I mean, they're still paying good money for it. So,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Give them quality work for sure.
That's fucking awesome, dude. That's cool, man. I love to see.
Hey, can I switch it up real quick?
What's up?
Go for it.
Like, what equipment would you say to stay away from and, like, go towards?
Because
I saw that one guy die from the Peloton.
Wait, what? Someone died from a Peloton?
I say,
what the hell is that?
Sex in the City.
Yo, right. But wait, in reality,
over here cracking what? Up, like,
yeah,
so inside joke.
Wait, did a guy really die from Peloton?
Sex in the City, you remember?
Who, the
big, right?
Big?
Yeah, big member.
I didn't know that that's how he died.
I think he had a heart attack or something.
Yeah, they didn't even have a heart attack.
Peloton.
Shut the fuck up.
That's why a lot of people are like, I'm never going to buy one.
Yeah,
that's
why I'm like. There was like a commercial that they kind of like, they actually got the actor or something like that, where they kind of like made fun of it. Or I don't know exactly what happened, but.
So should I stay away from it? No, I'm just kidding.
No, I mean, Peloton's good. Peloton's great. It's expensive as fuck, but. Yeah.
Is that kind of like a Tesla for like.
So here's the thing. Peloton is good. It's like I said, it's expensive. You're paying your subscription.
Whoever doesn't know, what is that?
Peloton's a, well, they do bikes. They it's do like spin bikes, and it's an interactive spin bike. So you have your trainer in front of you. You have a console, and it's like a nice big console. You pay a monthly subscription, and then you get to work out with trainers, and then they shout you out, I believe, or some other stuff.
Oh, okay. Really?
Yeah, yeah. Peloton's
so you're actually really like talking to someone,
Or is this like an animated? Yeah, it's just kind of like you log into a class, and then they kind of motivate you. They put your scores.
Like, come on, let's go.
I just fucking use my phone, dude. It's the same shit.
I always tell my clients, if you don't want to pay that, just get an iPad in front of your bike.
That's what I do.
And you put YouTube or something on, and you're good to go. I mean, and you get it for way cheaper price.
No, but the reason why I brought it up is because there's like so many machines out there. Like my daughter, we have a treadmill, right? Mm-hmm. And she wants to use it.
Yeah.
But I heard the story about Mike Tyson and his daughter, about how she...
I haven't heard about that one.
Well, so I don't know if it's true or not. Correct me if I'm wrong, but supposedly his daughter passed away because she tried using a treadmill.
Yeah.
She was 4. So I know sometimes they will fucking shoot out, you know?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Ever since I heard that story, I never let my daughter go on the treadmill.
Yeah. Well,
I'll be there with her, but no, dude, it's not...
You gotta supervise.
Yeah, you gotta supervise, obviously.
Like, don't make a run, but like do like a like a slow,
yeah, but
slow
pace. Walk, fucking, I see Final Destination 2.
or just walk around the block,
like,
you know.
What if that shit busts up by itself?
People are funny,
speed.
Man. They'll drive to the gym to use the treadmill, you know.
No, like, but there's also those machines too where I've seen where like the girls on TikTok where they're doing the leg thing and it gets stuck.
Oh yeah,
and that is a malfunction.
Wait, like, what leg thing?
The leg press.
Uh huh. And then
but one
of them they can't reach it. Se la tora la palanca.
Yeah.
And then it's actually broken. Like someone has to come stop them before their leg snaps. Like. You never
but
seen
isn't
those?
There like a stopper?
I mean, the stopper is what I've seen that breaks.
But like, I mean, that's also sometimes proper use. People try to overload certain things, and I've seen people kind of like, you know, put a bunch of plates and stuff.
That's why I don't go to the gym.
That's why I don't work out.
For safety reasons.
I seen a girl one time. She fucking locked her knees, bro, on that thing.
Yeah.
Oh,
she God. Fucking.
It went
fucking,
this way, bro.
She ostriched.
Oh, Lord.
She busted the ostrich.
That's all bad.
The
flamingo. Oh, shit. Nah, I'm good. I'll be over here. Like, all right.
That shit look like it hurt, bro. That shit gives me the fucking.
She's not doing that for a while.
Nah, I don't know.
She ain't doing shit for a while.
How do you recover from that?
I don't think you do. I mean, bro, her shit went this way. Like,
you
it's
just
almost,
you just cut them off at the knees and you're good, you know?
Nah, hell no. I can't be doing that. That's great. But you working with all that equipment is like, what's like the best equipment that can give you like a full all around fucking workout?
What's going to make me lose the most amount of weight in the last amount of time?
Stop eating, bitch.
Or the most popular equipment that you usually see at people's houses.
Some meth.
Stay away.
I remember I had a coworker.
You had what?
I had a coworker, and she was like,
"Don't name names."
Like, yeah, I'm not. Yeah, but she's like, "How do you lose weight?" And I'm like joking around, like, "Oh, meth, you know." And she's like, "Can you get me some?" And like, I thought she was like kidding, you know.
Yeah.
And like, she kept bugging me all week, like, "Hey, let me get it, you know."
Showed up with some like, oil, man.
Yeah. Hey, she was probably already on it, fool. So
yeah, she's like, "I'm trying to lose weight fast." I'm like, and I'm joking, you know, joking, but not really. I didn't want to give it to her because I didn't want to ruin her life.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But like, yeah, she kept bugging. I was like, "Well, just go to the gym," you know? She's like, "Nah." Like a year later, she got like a whole
BBL.
Everything. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's the best. I think that's the easiest.
But yeah, she was like, "Yeah, give me some." Like, for real. I was like, "Oh shit, caught me off guard," you know?
Yeah.
Like, we're not even that cool, you know?
Wait, but do you, besides working on it, do you work out too?
He didn't even answer the question.
I know. Well, that's what I'm trying to get to after that.
Right. I mean, you know, I do a couple reps here and there.
Yeah.
Honestly, like, I always joke to my customers, like I told you, like, the whole expensive coat rack and all. Make sure you use it, you know, all that stuff. No excuses now. I have a full gym at my house. I get home every day.
Wait, do you really?
Oh, 100%.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, 100%. I have a squat rack. I have a, you know, elliptical. I have a bike. I have a treadmill. And there's a lot of towels around it. I fall into it too, you know. But with my job, it's a very physical job, so it allows me to maintain. Obviously, I'm not in the best shape possible. But you know, I'm trying out the gym equipment. I'm trying out the treadmills. I'm trying out the ellipticals. You know, sometimes I get to people's houses and they're like, hey, you know, my elliptical's not working. But after 30 minutes on level 10 incline, you know, 15, I'm like, all right, gotta go get after it. So and then we're also doing deliveries. So that's it's a physical job. So it's
yeah.
Not, so we do a little bit of everything. So like my job is a blessing, dude. Honestly, like it allows me to stay physically active and not really have to work out too much. Yeah. But definitely that's on the goals.
Do sure. you like whenever you go do like a delivery delivery to people's houses and like let's say for example you're delivering a certain type of equipment, right? Mm-hmm. A treadmill. Let's just keep it that way.
Yep.
I'm pretty sure whenever you get to a customer's house, they'll ask you questions about that equipment. Do you feel like you have to inform yourself by trying out all those type of different equipments at home or on your own time so that you can be able to like tell them from experience?
I mean, yeah, with every, that helps? I think with every profession, you have to know exactly what you're doing. You have to be able to give some information, kind of like not necessarily a trainer, but provide them with information so they can kind of like get started.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people just have the mindset of, okay, I want to lose weight. What's the first thing I'm going to do? I'm going to go out and buy some gym equipment. They go on Google, best treadmill, best elliptical, best bike. Yeah. And the first thing that pops up, that's what I'm going to get.
Yeah.
So, I mean, they definitely have like an idea of what they want to do. But yeah, when we get there, we explain everything, how it works, the ins and outs. And yeah.
That's dope.
You know, we set them up right.
Hell yeah, that's dope.
Yeah, man.
Have you ever like have you taken any classes to obviously like further your kind of further your knowledge, you know?
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
Do you take classes and stuff like
so,
that? Do you
go to so like I mentioned that a lot of this is kind of self-taught, and you know, obviously he's my father's the master technician, so he's taught me. I've been in the business for about 10 years now. Since I was about 18, on and off. But a lot of the times, too, we do have to get certified. So we go out to the manufacturing companies, and they do, like, a course. And you have to pass tests and get certified so that when people do contact them and they can refer us, we make sure we have the proper certifications.
Okay, that's dope.
That's good.
We have, like, kind of, like, the diplomas that they give out and all that stuff. So, yeah, there is courses and stuff, but they kind of just...
That's a good portfolio to have,
too. Yeah, exactly. And that's why, you know... That's why we've maintained in the business for so long, because we do keep up to date with all that stuff.
Nice.
Mm. So yeah, it's there's a little bit of everything.
And believe it or not, people always look at that too.
Oh yeah, like, definitely.
I mean, your
they clients? Ask us for the certification.
I mean, you could just lie and say, yeah, I got it. Like they never like.
He said they ask him for their certification. Oh, man.
But like they ask him, like, yeah. Do you have it? He could say, yeah.
Yeah.
But do they ever ask you for like the physical?
There's not a lot of people. That
diploma.
Do. No.
Maybe I mean, like a Karen here and there.
Every once in a while, like I said, we do definitely. To deal with with a lot of richer people that feel
I mean entitled some yeah sometimes. And then dude I'm pretty sure they don't want to fucking just bring anyone into their house, you know?
Exactly So I mean there is a certain sense of professionalism that we have to carry.
No, yeah, for sure.
How we talk, how we kind of like, you know, provide the service, how we explain certain things. I mean, I think that goes a long way, you know?
Yeah.
So presentation is key, man.
Oh yeah,
you gotta dress how you want to be addressed.
Oh, I like that. Yeah. Nice.
So, I was watching Edward Scissorhands the other day, and then the housewives are like, she would just call over the guy to come fix the dishwasher just because she was bored. And then, so like came into my head right now, like, do you ever get like those? Because you said you deal with a lot of housewives and all that. Yeah. Do they ever like get inappropriate?
So I'm probably, I'll say no comment on that one.
Yeah.
I think my wife's gonna tune in, but.
I mean,
I can only imagine.
They're very nice.
I'm pretty
they're
sure.
Very
nice.
Because I think it's a movie, you know. But in reality, it's like, hell no, there probably is crazy people out there like that.
No, 100%, 100%. We've dealt with a lot of different people.
Yeah, no, for sure, dude. I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure you guys get
a lot of different scenarios. You know, we like I said, I've been working in this company for 10 years, so we've seen everything.
And then I'm pretty sure you meet people from all types of walks of life, you know. And
definitely,
I'm pretty sure you'd be going to like some crazy ass mansion looking houses and definitely. Stuff like that.
San Diego's very beautiful, and I said, North County is just gorgeous, bro. It's there's a lot of money up there for
makes
sure.
Makes you feel like shit.
The way I look at it,
it motivates you.
No,
it inspires me to do better. You know, I see this and I say, okay, this is obtainable. It's not just. I don't know. It's not just a fantasy. It's like people. There's a reason why somebody's here. And then, I mean, you just have to have the right mindset.
Yeah.
A lot of people that I've met started from nothing as well. So they can relate to us. You know, they love the family-owned companies. And they tell me their success stories. And it's okay. It's not that far off from where we're at.
Yeah,
that's for sure.
So when I used to work in Poway too, I remember seeing the houses, and I used to be like, "Fuck, this is beautiful."
Yeah,
like
sure.
This is attainable. For
They're definitely living in a different world, but it's not impossible.
There's a lot of money out there, man.
Oh yeah, you know? That's why I love talking to people. Like, dude, me, I've never had a job where I have to deliver things to a home ever. You know, so every time I talk to someone that has that opportunity, bro, like, I could just imagine the shit they see, bro. Like, you know?
Dude, I fucking met Antonio Gates, way.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
and
that's crazy.
And I didn't
crazy.
Know it was Antonio Gates.
Oh, wow.
She had no clue.
I told Leo, I was like, I don't know who he was. And he stood next to the car.
His last name is Gates or something?
Yeah.
And I remember I called him. I was like, fuck, I forgot the package. I got to go back. And then I read the name out loud. He's like, Antonio Gates. He delivered to him. I'm like, yeah, I was just there. And then...
Yeah,
we definitely, like, you know, if it's a really nice house, we'll Google it sometimes and make sure.
Like, oh, really?
Yeah, like, dude, I remember when I was like, I used to deliver like from Del Mar, PB, like all the way to Point Loma.
Yep. Yeah.
All along like beach houses, you know? Mm-hmm. And I used to be like in Del Mar, like, oh, where do you stay? I'm like, San Isidro.
Where?
They'd be like, oh, they're one of those.
They're like, oh, fuck.
Here, have a water app.
Yeah, so I started saying Chula Vista. They were like a little better, you know?
Yeah.
I was like, South okay. Bay. Yeah. I'll leave it over.
From the South Bay.
Yeah, fuck, like,
National
Norman.
City?
Yeah. But I feel you on the Lonely Housewives, because we used to show up with refrigerators.
Yeah.
Workout equipment, fucking multi-million dollar house. Like it's over here, like.
I don't have money, but you know? Is there anything I can pay you with?
Oh, yeah. Shit.
Dude, this guy used to open the door in his robe when I used to do the route, and he would know, like, the pattern of when I would do the route. So then my manager ended up going out there because they knew he was going to do that, and they fucking reported his ass, and they blocked him so no one could ever deliver there because he was being a fucking nasty ass. And that's what I was telling you. Like, it's crazy.
That would probably be me.
But what's wrong with opening, like, your robe?
He was naked.
Oh, he was naked.
And he was like ready for me to deliver the package.
It was like, oh shit.
Hey, Shanice would always go like, because you know how they have the little on the door, the little people. She would go like this instead of like, just dropping it. Just
eye level.
I would like stop and tie my shoe. Just kidding.
Oh hell no.
Just kidding.
That's that 2023 glory hole out. Right there.
I was watching something about that the other day. They're like, they need to bring those back.
Oh, hell yeah.
They're like, hell no. You know what's glory behind holes. That shit.
True.
Well, yeah, now, bro. Well, never mind. Never mind.
The conversation.
I don't want.
Yep. Oh, man, cut. That, no,
that's
kidding.
Done. Yeah.
I had like three at my old house. Nah, I bet you.
Oh, hell no.
Anyways, bro. Yeah. What do you, where do you see yourself like in the next 5 years with that company? What do you like? What type of grow do you think you will be doing?
Yeah, right. So I have a new employee, and me and him have already been talking about our goals and aspirations. One of my biggest goals is to be the service technician for the San Diego Padres. Now, I'm calling it out there right now. You know what I mean? Like,
it's you got to speak it to existence, bro.
100%. And,
dude, I hope you do.
Yeah. It's not impossible. Like I said, we just got to get ourselves out there. We have a lot of hotels right around the Petco Park area already that we do service and contracts for or maintenance. And then I feel like like I said, we just need a couple more employees to really make ourselves official. It's family owned, but it's getting there.
That's dope.
So mm-hmm. that's one of my biggest goals, San Diego Padres. And unfortunately, the Chargers are no longer here. That was my previous goal when I was younger.
You got SDSU down the street.
Yeah, we've done SDSU.
Yeah,
before.
And they got
mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good. And they got that. Good. And they got that new stadium too, bro.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
That's right.
You know, I'm pretty sure they have a gym in the stadium. You know,
yeah, they should. Yeah, I haven't really peeped it out there, but yeah, that's one of my biggest goals that I feel is obtainable within the next 5 years for sure.
Yeah, definitely. No, for sure. I could totally see you guys doing that all the mm-hmm. way, especially with the will that you have and the knowledge that your dad has, bro.
Yeah.
I think you and him can make a fucking for sure like badass team. Like, that also goes to like show like maybe that's why he doesn't want to retire either yet, you know? Because I know that. Even though you have the updated fucking knowledge and the smarts and all that, he could still give you fucking lots of help and shit, you know? Every like
day. That's the
like,
fun
it's
thing.
It's like the sensei, yeah. You know? They exactly. never give you the all the information, you know? Yeah. They always hold that last piece yeah. for when you're ready for
yeah.
it, you know?
Oh, yeah.
You know what I like about being an entrepreneur is that when you put your foot, let's just say when you do get that thing, the Padres contract, let's say, like your foot is in the door and it's an endless opportunity and your dad is not going to want to stop there. Oh, like no, he's no. going to be like, oh my God, dude.
Let's keep going.
Yeah.
Like
at this point, with you on the team, he's probably like, I want to see where this goes.
It feels good. Yeah. It feels no, good attaining those like goals yeah. along the way.
I mean, at one point, bro, once you reach the Padres, like, the Major League Baseball is going to be the next thing, you know? Yeah. Like, fuck that. Why don't we have Nationwide. A contract with... Let's go. Why don't we have a fucking contract with every fucking stadium, every yeah. fucking team, you know?
Hey, we got a guy, Manny, you know? He's really exactly. good. We'll That's crazy. Number. Like,
yeah. I mean, hopefully, exactly. bro, I really hope you fucking...
Me too, dude.
I know you will. Sick. You know why? Because I see that drive in you, yeah. dog. Like,
my gente, rato en el military, yeah? Military base?
We do a lot of military, too.
Oh, nice.
There you go.
Yeah, what? We do Camp Pendleton. We do a lot of the Navy shit. Oh, yeah,
that's
shit.
True. That's Damn. Fucking amazing. Yeah,
we're already in there. Like, a lot of the government contracts, we do the Border Patrol. We do police departments, fire departments. Like I said, it's a small company, but we have a big grasp on a lot of things that we do. So that's
awesome, awesome, dog. How that's do you guys fucking manage? Awesome.
That's crazy.
Yeah. We got to give it up for you guys, yeah, dog. Yeah, straight
definitely,
up.
Definitely. Thank you.
That's
I appreciate
fucking
you.
Dope, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, you're on the right path for sure.
100%.
Yeah, bro.
I feel it.
To me, bro.
2023.
The small. I don't know, bro. It's just one. There's not that many. There's not that much competition.
Right, and that's the best part about it.
Yeah, dog. And then
take full advantage.
Yeah, for sure. And
if there is competition, I always like to remind people there's enough for everybody.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
There's always enough for everybody, and then it's you.
Yeah.
People are there for you. Mm-hmm. And. It's you,
yeah.
you know?
Yeah.
So you need to present yourself in a way where people...
At the end of the day, like, as long as you do a good job, yeah. like, no matter what, like, best, no matter how man. Many... You know, like, I can give a one person a haircut, and if I fucking make their haircut so fucking, like, so... if I give them such a... If Crispy. I give them a great experience, you know, mm-hmm. a great experience, a great haircut... Something that that they can remember me forever. Mm-hmm. Exactly. I'm Make good. Like, you know? You know, mm-hmm. memorable haircut. Yeah. There you go.
People remember that. The yeah. way that yeah. you sure. treat them. Because you can get a fire-ass haircut somewhere. But what if the guy's a fucking asshole? Or yeah. like, yeah. you know what I mean?
Oh, definitely.
I wouldn't.
Well, here's the thing. Like, people will remember how you make them feel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know? You so if you them? Make them feel, mm-hmm. like, important or whatever, that you give them good advice.
Yeah.
You know, they're going to remember you forever as opposed to someone that's just that like whatever.
Yeah. yeah.
You mm-hmm. know,
it's so cool to making clients like friends.
Yeah.
I've experienced that recently and I love it.
We have clients that we've had for, you know, 10 plus years that they see me as his trainer, as his, what do you call it when you're kind of shadowing somebody?
Like an yeah. apprentice.
Yeah. yeah. And now for me to have my own apprentice and have several people underneath me, and then they see me as a master technician now. And then I remember when you were, you know, this tall, when you were carrying your
yeah,
dad's bag.
Me.
And
yeah.
Exactly. And they see me grow and evolve. And it's just like, I mean, that's a beautiful thing.
This yeah.
Thing, you know? It's definitely a service that we provide.
Too.
Exactly. You know, and I have my, yeah. my son and you know, if he wants to, he wants yeah. to do this, you know, that's what I'm trying to set this up for.
Yeah. I mean, that's why not, dude? Yeah. I think that's the way it should be, yeah. mm-hmm. you know, to keep it in the family, man.
Yeah. 100%.
I think that's the best way to run a business, bro. I mean, obviously, you know, a lot of times like shit can hit the fan, but for the most part, bro, like, man, if you could teach your son that, if you could keep it going.
Yeah.
Pff, that'd be the fucking,
yeah, it's definitely not
the right move.
Not easy, but it's fucking worth it.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, you know,
So now let's go. Let's go to the business owner mm-hmm. side of this, bro. Mm-hmm. What do you think it takes to run such a great business like yours? What do you think it takes?
I mean, it takes a lot. It takes a lot of drive. You definitely got to care. You got to be passionate about what you do. You just every single day, man, in and out. I mean, it's a new day. You got to get after it. You know.
Yeah.
You gotta want it.
Consistency.
Exactly. That's, yeah. that's the main key. Consistency is never be complacent. Never half-ass anything that you do. You got to put your pride, you know, into it. You know, you got to give your people quality work day in, day out. It doesn't matter if you're having a bad day. Like every client that you do, it's like you got to start over and give them your best face at the end of the day.
Yes, yeah. sir.
And provide your best service.
Hell yeah,
sure.
dude.
Yeah.
I love
yeah,
that.
That'll affects that'll your go a long way. Too.
What I've been, like, hearing and reading a lot lately is, like, your success is determined by your self-development. So you have to work on yourself in order to be successful somewhere else.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That's what I've been reading a lot lately.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean, that's understandable.
And
I
it's like, you got to work on yourself, be the better, like your vices. Like, if you can't, like, quit talking to yourself negatively, then what makes you think you're going to be able to do anything else?
Yeah.
You
yeah.
know? You got to be able to, like, switch your mindset and, like, think positive.
Yeah. It's like like the people that are always giving good advice, but then they don't take their own advice, you know? Like, make sure you take that shit in before you fucking start giving people advice. Like,
you know, you got to lead by example.
Yeah, no, all the way. Yeah, yeah.
And how are you going to tell your kid, like, oh, I could do this?
Yeah.
But then you're just at home doing shit.
That's why, bro. Like, that's why I work the way I work, dog. Like, and you know this, man. I fucking work.
It's like your dad. Like, he gave you the example.
Yep.
You know, so you got to live up to that, you know, as opposed to someone's dad that was like, you know,
bullshitting,
you know, like, my dad's telling me this, but he's doing that, you know, like, what the fuck?
I hate to, I hate it. You know what I fucking hate, bro? Like, when I have a barber dog that, like, doesn't show up to work, or he does, but then he leaves, and then it comes, comes, and then he's not putting in hours, and then he tells me, fuck, I'm struggling with fucking paying rent, or, like, I'm struggling with fucking bills, and I'm like, motherfucker, you're not here.
Where you at?
Like, you only come, like, six hours of the day.
Just, like, three
And then he'll be like, I don't know. I can't fucking do it. It's dead. And I'm like, dude, like, I can do it, dog. Like, and it, or like when they tell me, like, dead. I can't do it. And I'm like, look, bro, let me show you. That's why I work the way I work.
That's
you know?
The one they're supposed to be at work the most.
Yeah. You know? Like, that's why I'm always the way I work the way I work. Cause ain't nobody can tell me you can't do this shit out here. Cause I can do it.
Hello.
You can do it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then they leave and then fucking six walk-ins come in. You know? It's like, motherfucker.
And it seems to happen
here,
that way, dog. Like, it seems that when you give up is when shit fucking, you know, and when opportunities come. Mm-hmm. You know what
I'm
saying?
That's life testing you.
Yeah, for sure. Don't fold. Exactly, dog. Yeah.
Have you guys ever experienced that? Like, when you feel you're just like, oh, like, I'm like, I don't want to go to work. I'm fucking over it. I don't even feel like I got it in me. I'm losing motivation. And then you're like, you know what? Fuck it. This could be my day. And you just get up and you show up and you have like the best fucking day of your life. Yep. You're like, I was ready to give up like 10 minutes ago. Mm-hmm. And I'm here and I got this fucking opportunity.
Yeah.
And I feel this way. And you're just like, fuck, like. That's the fucking devil way.
I always know, low key,
I feel like that sometimes, you know? It's like I get just so caught up in my mind and my thoughts that I'm like,
your mind plays tricks on you.
I'm like, oh, I have all this shit to worry about. Like, I don't want to go to work because I have this. But then, like, I come to work.
That's when you got to give it your best.
I come to work and I start, you know, getting in the groove and I start like hustling.
Then you get hyped by Polo.
Yeah, I get hyped and then like all these answers start coming. You know,
that'll do it.
All these answers start coming. It's like, you know
what? Yeah.
The trick is to do what you got to do, no matter how you feel.
You know something that I always remember when I'm feeling like fuck, bro. Like, you're always gonna find something that's gonna make you like fucking snap out of it or push. You know, something that I always like. Something that I always look for when I feel down, bro, is literally, bro, I'll fucking just start listening to Nipsey Hussle, to his interviews, bro, to motivational shit like that. Like he says one day, bro, like he says, like, people think this shit was easy. Like, they don't understand that I went through every emotion you can think of to get to where I am now. Like,
it's not overnight,
bro,
you know?
This shit doesn't fucking just happen out of nowhere, bro. Like, you fucking, like, and it doesn't just happen from one day to another, bro. Like, this shit took him years, bro. It took him years. Like, this guy literally died, like, 2-3 years after he was barely getting, like,
where he wanted to be,
like,
kind of.
You know, he was barely popping. Like, he was a known rapper, and he was a really good rapper, yes. But he wasn't never, like, he was, like, he got, he was nominated for a Grammy, like, a year before. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't like he was already fucking huge fucking years prior. Nah, this fool literally became a Grammy-nominated artist. And then, like, 2 years later, boom, dies. You know, and this fool on an interview, he says, like, sometimes you'll fucking feel like you're over it, like you're done, like you just want to fucking give up. But you got to remember that you're already so far from where you started that you're closer to the end than you are to fucking the beginning. So why even go back, bro? Just keep fucking going. Yeah. You're almost there. You're not that far, you know? Like, the beginning is further away, homie. Fuck that. Keep going.
Most people will give up and then start a new thing, and then they'll go through the same shit.
You know, the
same emotions. Just keep going with the fuck you want to do, and then, you know. Yeah.
This is kind of the same thing, but my suegra, I always have this phrase in my head where she's like, yo ya vengo, tú apenas vas. Like, it's pretty much saying like, oh, I'm already on my way back. You're barely going. So then she tells me this when I'm like struggling with like, oh, I can't put this fucking, I don't know how to do something in the house, right? And then she's like, here, let me help you. And she tells me, and I'm like, what the fuck? How'd you come up with that? She's like, I'm already on my way back, homegirl. You're barely going. Like, and I'm putting those things.
There's a lot of life to live, man.
And that's why, and I put it in my head, like, I got a long way to go. Like, I got to get that. I'm trying to come up with those fucking things and put it under my belt, how she did. You know what I mean? And that's just a part of
fucking going through hardship. You got to try to do it, you know? Most people...
Damn, one of my best friends right now is going into labor right now.
Is that why he called us and I didn't answer?
Canseco.
Oh, my God. We lost.
No. Don't answer. Fuck that.
Fuck that. We'll call him back. They're going to be there for a while.
Yeah, they will be there for a while.
It's the first one.
Hey,
we'll call him tomorrow morning. They'll be straight.
Talking about that, dog. Talking about kids.
I know. We got sidetracked.
How hard is it for you to put in, like, because, dude, you're basically like me, bro. You leave your house early and you don't come back till it's nighttime.
Yeah.
How do you manage your life, your personal life and your fucking work life when, you know how a lot of people say like, oh, fucking 9 to 5, I'm open up a fucking business. And it's like, bro, you're going to, you're never
24/7,
homie. You don't fucking, you never stop grinding, dog.
I mean, I think it always starts with a good woman next to you, right?
Fuck yeah.
You know, that's,
hell yeah.
Shout out to my wife too.
Hell yeah. Big shout out to your wife.
Shout out to the wife.
Yeah, for sure. Cause without her, I don't think anything any of this would be possible.
Real shit, bro.
First time I ever heard somebody say that.
Yeah. No. And I mean, that's my whole purpose too. Like, that's the reason why I work so hard, why I go so hard and why I strive to obtain so much things is cause, I mean, yeah, I would have a motivation, but, you know, I would be sidetracked. I would get distracted with her and my son. It's like, that's all my focus. That's my purpose.
Yeah.
100%.
Yeah, there's no, like, what's the word I'm looking for? There's no sacrifice for them, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I'm going to do what I got to do,
I don't want them to ever struggle, so, hey, like, that to me isn't an option.
I don't know if this happens to you guys, and I'm talking to you guys, like, as a guy.
Uh-huh.
Like, I always tell her, like, fuck, like, sometimes she'll call me and she'll, like, bitch at me about something that's
wrong
at home, you know, like, fuck, like, you left the fucking mess in the room, why didn't you buy, and then I'm like, wow, like, nigga, I'm having such a great day at work, I'm like so fucking good, but then you called me and then I feel like I fucked up at home, and then shit's weird, and then my day's kind of like, everything fuck, you know, like I feel like when you, and this is every once in a while, it's like, for the most part, like, my girl's always fucking legit as fuck, you know, but what I'm trying to say is, like, when you have a good woman next to you, bro, and shit's good at home where she's, like, taking care of everything at home, and then you guys are a good team and all that, like, I feel like us as guys, we perform even better at fucking at work, you know? Like, you know, you're just happy, dog.
One less thing to worry about.
Exactly, you know? Like, you're just so happy.
It's because we know our role, you know? I don't... No one take this the wrong way, you know? But
fucking Andrew Tate ass over here.
Like, but our women, they know their role.
The house,
the kids,
work.
Know, women got to be women, men got to be men.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, dude,
and that's I love when it.
And that's when it works out the best.
Yeah.
I love it.
You know,
you
get a woman trying to be a man, well, fucking, you go to work, I'm going to stay at home, fucking stay with the kids, you know?
Yeah.
You want to talk shit.
Yeah.
You know? Fucking, you go work 80 hours a week. I'll chill. I'll wash the dishes, do laundry.
Plus.
You will never hear a phone call
complaining
about fucking.
Babe, what the fuck? You call him back.
Did you wear these chonas yesterday? You know, like, what the fuck? But you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like we're lucky enough to have women that know their role and let us do.
Yeah,
they handle their shit, but, and they let us do what we need to do to.
I gotta give women props too, though. The women that actually work and fucking and they hold it down at home, bro. Like, that's amazing too, dog. You know, like sometimes
I do. Sometimes, like, I bitch, but fuck.
Like that's dope because fuck, dude, I couldn't imagine being able to fucking like get off of work and then have to wash for my wife. That. Like, fuck.
I'm like, I'm gonna go to
do the homework. I'm like, do the laundry.
The way I think, I'm like, you know what? Fuck laundry. I'm gonna go to a Dickies store, get a $4 shirt. And I'm straight up. You
Yeah.
I'll wash when I can.
You know what's crazy? We're inside out.
You know what's I know, right? You know what's crazy? I have an uncle, bro, that my mom used to tell me that this fool would literally, like, he didn't know how to wash clothes, so this fool would just throw, he would buy socks and then wear them, throw them, like, for 2-3 days, throw them out and go buy new ones because he didn't know how to wash. You know?
Fuck it. There's a sink right there, my boy, you know?
So it's like, fuck. Nah, but big shout out to the women that hold it down, bro, because they're...
Bro, funny story.
Yeah, go ahead.
So my mom used to do my laundry, right? That was like her hold against me.
Yeah.
So like whenever I'd fuck up, you know, I'm not going to wash your shit. You go do it. Like, oh man, I would hit up my homies. I would hit up my homies' girls. Yeah. I would make them go do my laundry.
I mean, you shoot them a quick 50. Yeah, or 30, you know,
hook them up a little bit. But yeah,
and then your mom gets mad at you, like, motherfucker, you could have just gave it to me. You could have paid me, fucker.
I'm over here walking into the house like full of laundry, like, yeah, fuck, I don't need you.
Nah, hey, I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. I've never, not once in my life, ever washed laundry, bro.
I don't even know how to turn on the machine.
My girl has told me, like, hey, go put this in the washer. And I'm like,
you know what?
He's so hyperventilating.
Oh, you're like, I'm like, what the fuck do I do? Like, I can't even tell the laundry and the fucking dryer apart, fool. Like,
it goes on YouTube.
If they told me that, you'll see me
in the dryer.
if you told me that, I'll be in the fucking bathtub with Zote. Fucking, this is the only way I know right here.
I've never done that. Like, my mom washed my clothes when I was a kid, and then once I became like a teenager, my sister started washing my clothes. And then once I fucking met her, she took over, you know, like,
they know the rules, baby.
They literally like, my sister was like, all right, you guys are serious, it's your turn, you know. So like, and for me, I've never done, I mean, I've washed dishes, I'll take that.
Hell,
but hey, I know, right? Fucking give me some, baby. Yeah. Hey. But you know what's fucked up? I used to get mad because I used to wash dishes, fool. And then my mom, fool, I swear to God, my mom and my sister, fool, they would fucking behind my back. They would be like, hey, who washed the dishes? All right, fool. They would put them back and rewash them, fool.
Yeah.
And I'd be like, and I caught them, fool, one time. And my mom was like, no, mija, don't tell him. Like, no le digas nada, you know? Like,
tenedor todavía en la carne todavía, la verdad.
And I fucking heard him, fool. And I was like, you're telling me I've been washing them and you guys rewash them? They're like, yeah, my mom, fuck y'all. I'm never washing a dish in my life. You know?
True.
Like, it's...
Yo que culpa tengo.
I was like...
You gotta, it's because you gotta touch them. You gotta rub them.
You gotta make sure that, like, the food,
I mean, but I did.
The oil.
I'm over here thinking, like, hey, what the fuck? Like,
here's a life hack for all the guys watching. When you get with your girl, you do the laundry, it's time for both of you to fold. Fold it like shit.
Yep.
Because... That's what happened to me.
I thought I was the only one.
I was like, just whatever, it's gonna fit.
No, it has to be Steph's like this. Like, I'll
no,
just do it.
No. Leave it alone. I'm gonna fold it. All right.
Yeah.
Handles, you know.
He doesn't even try. He just fucking.
Yeah. Hey, as long as it fits in the drawer, we're good.
Yeah.
I know where it's at.
Man, you know? You're saying a little bit quiet over there.
No, I mean, that's personal experience right there, too. Yeah. Sure.
He's just right here, like, yeah.
I don't know how to fold baby clothes.
Nah, you know what's crazy, though? Like, my girl, she'll be
just
like,
crumple up in the ball and just.
Like, my girl, she'll do my drawer, right?
Just
she'll
throw it on the elliptical,
nah, fool. You'll be fine,
right? Like, my girl will make my shit all night, like, all fucking nice, right?
I fucking used to color coordinate it and everything.
But then me, like, I want to wear something, I'll put it on. I'm like, I didn't like it, so I just throw it. And then she'll be like, what the fuck? I just fixed your drawer. And I'm like, I didn't ask you to. And like, you know, I didn't tell you to do it, but, like, you know, I just know how my shit is, like, when it's all crumbled up and shit, you know?
It's an organized mess.
Yeah, exactly. It's an organized mess. But it's, I don't know. Shout out to the women, bro. Big shout out to the women.
Big shout out, bro.
Thank you, baby. I appreciate that.
I would be a horrible girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Shout out horrible. To the men, though. Working fucking, hard, too.
You have terrible gag reflexes.
Yeah, I fucking hate brushing my teeth. You should hear me.
I'm not gonna ask how you guys know that, man.
Oh shit. Well, we brush our teeth here, dog. That's why.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah. Oh man. Nah, man, but I salute you, dog. You're doing a great job. I'm pretty sure your dad is probably hesitant to let go of the company, but I know he knows the company is in great hands.
Oh, yeah.
With you, bro, you know, cuz not only are you bettering the company, you know, you are considerate that your dad started this company, you know, from ground up. And And I mean, who else would you rather give your company that you built on your own? Who would you rather give it to rather than your son, you know?
100%.
I just think that's it's a win-win for both of you, you know? He left you something great and you're picking up and going further with it, continuing, exactly. You know?
Mm-hmm. Have you ever felt like you need to do something else besides this?
Yeah, I was just gonna ask you. That's crazy.
So I always
feel like pressured because it's like a family business?
No, definitely. So when I was younger, like I said, I've been on and off with him for about 10 years now. And when I was younger, it felt like a huge pressure, mm-hmm. to succeed him and to fill his shoes. And I always said sometimes it's easier to follow than it is to lead. And that was the biggest thing with him. It's like he had this company, he had this opportunity, and man, it's a big pressure to make sure that you make all the right decisions, you know. But I started learning that even though they're not all right, you got to just put your best foot forward and just got to continue and give everything you got to it. So now it's not, I don't think about that anymore. I just think about what's the best that I can do and not really think about of him, kind of like, I don't, not necessarily right, right, right. him, but you know, you kind of,
yeah,
you know,
I get, no, try I get that, it. Like, you know, yeah, like
I'm not trying to,
you like, wake up every day and you're like trying to be the best you, exactly. And not really trying to impress him.
Exactly. And that allows me to kind of like flow a lot better, to work a lot better and not have that surmount amount of pressure.
Well, that's good.
Over
that's mm-hmm. That's a good way of thinking right there. Not a lot of people think that way. You
it's
know,
like a peace of mind for yourself too.
Exactly.
To like perform better for yourself.
For sure. For sure.
It's like holding an expectation and then you get disappointed because you don't reach it, you know? Right. But if you wake up every day and you're just like, oh, I'm gonna be a little bit better than I was yesterday. And it's like,
and it's not at least that, the same thing. It's two different worlds too, you know? Like what you're coming up with and how he was and.
Yeah, no, and I know for a fact, I mean, we've had plenty of conversations that, you know, he understands that the way he built this company, and it's like, okay, he had a certain vision for it. Now it's my turn, and then he's allowing me to.
I can move over, old guy.
No, not even that, you know what I mean? But it almost feels like that. Like, he's like, oh, I'm not done yet. I still got time to go. And it's like, okay, perfect, but.
But based on your experience, I'm sure you see things that he doesn't really see because of the lack of experience. Yeah. From the new life,
wave, the new era, exactly, you know, the social media, all that, you know, the online campaign and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. So, like I said, it's really where I come in and kind of like I bridge that connection to him and allow him to understand that now. So, I mean,
have you explained to him like how like Instagram works with businesses and like
online marketing?
For the most part, I have explained to him, and he's, like I said, he's a little bit hesitant to really like let loose and create a budget for marketing and all that stuff. But now, after explaining, after really like talking to him, having a one-on-one conversation, and really say, okay, like, look, you've had this company for 25 years plus, it's giving you so much. But imagine if you had five of me's, you know what I mean, running the show, and
or
you
a whole be team, dog, a whole like a whole team, marketing,
you know,
team,
10 plus people that really just want the best for this company, and that's where you could have been. And he's bought in now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And so it's like, he's giving me the,
it's cool that he's open to it.
Yeah. Oh, 100%. I mean, it wasn't a thing that it was kind of like easy. He was, like I said, he's very hesitant and it's his baby, you know, regardless if it's his son, you know, trying to run it and trying to make sure it's a bigger company. He was always, you know, very hesitant to not overinvest into something that's not going to pay out.
Yeah.
And that's what I told him. I was like, hey, you know what? Like, this is not going to fail. I can't fail you. Yeah. I can't, you know, it's only going to go up.
You know that, there's big companies, like, for example, Cox or like fucking 24 Hour Fitness, mm-hmm. and all those big companies, you know that they invest millions.
Oh, yeah.
A year, bro, in marketing, online marketing, just the like.
Now you gotta jump like, a reel with Omatic.
Like they yeah, for real. Like they really fucking just on Facebook, bro. They spend like $500,000 a year just on Target, like on Target website. They spend $200,000 a year, you know, and every little fucking website they spend a certain amount of money that at the end it just adds up to millions, bro.
Do you know how much Tesla spent on marketing?
How much?
Nothing, because they don't have commercials. It's all word of mouth.
Yeah, that's true. I never seen a Tesla commercial. Yeah,
it's all it's same with Rolls Royce, Lamborghinis.
I remember because
people
that realize the quality that can't afford it and that know the quality, they don't need somebody to tell them about it.
Exactly.
I heard one time too, Lamborghini doesn't do marketing or commercials because the people that can own it aren't watching TV.
Yeah.
There you go.
You know, they're not wasting their time doing that.
Yeah.
So.
True story, man. Oh. Fuck TV. Go to work. Fuck you. Work hard. No one cares.
That's why I watch everything on my phone. Not on TV.
Nobody cares, man. Work harder.
Real shit, man. But yeah, bro. Thank you for coming out here and talking with us, bro.
It went by fast.
I mean, I love inviting people that have a business mindset, entrepreneur mindset. Mm-hmm. It's people that just want to grow and do better all the time. You know, I just love hanging around and talking with people because that shit motivates me to do better, bro.
Yeah,
like,
it does.
All the time. I love that shit. Like, I like to feed off of other people's energy, good energy, you know, not bad energy. So thank you for coming out here, bro. I invited you for a reason, you know,
Definitely.
Not just because you're just another person to have here. I really, really like invite people that that I'm going to benefit off of, but kind of, you know,
in a
good way, you know, not like I ain't going to fucking take your money. None of that shit, you know, because I hope you guys know, like, I don't ever fucking ask. I never get paid for this. I haven't even seen a single dime or anything like this. You know, I just see potential and I want to learn, man. Like everybody, like your boy was saying, Smitty, like other people's problems can teach other people solutions to their problems, you know. So thank you for coming out, dog. We've already fucking this. Now we're already past, bro. You know, I see you here all the time, and thank you for you know, coming in here to the shop, because I actually gained a friend, you know, and someone that's knowledgeable in life, you know, and that's what I'm really looking for, bro. Like, to keep fucking growing my circle, and
now people know, don't throw away your equipment.
Yeah,
get it fixed.
You know what
and,
to call.
And also. I want to bring you exposure, bro. I want people to know, like, I know we have a lot of clients here that have a gym at home that are probably asking themselves, like, or that have a broken treadmill or a broken piece of equipment at home that don't know who to call. Hopefully they see this episode and they can call you. So what I would like for you to do now is let people know how they can reach you guys or you so that they can get in contact with you.
Yeah, definitely. So we're on Instagram at sdfitservices.com, 888-745-0006. You can give us a call anytime. I mean, we're locally. Just give us a call and we can definitely help you out. Like I said, we're the solution to all fitness repairs.
Mm-hmm. Nice. I like
that's
that.
The slogan that
like
we have.
That. I like that. Yeah,
thank you, bro. Hope to see you back one day. Yeah, you know, I hope to see you back once you guys get the Padre contract going. Yeah. You know, one day. You know, hopefully, and speak it into existence, 100%. Dog. You know, and never let nothing stop you from growing. Keep doing what you're doing and make your dad happy, bro. And make yourself your family too. Happy. Make yourself happy. And bro, that's all I can say. Thank you for coming out, dog. It was a pleasure having out you here.
Thank you.
Remember, you guys can always watch us on YouTube or listen to us on any podcast streaming platform, Google Podcast, Apple Podcast, Spotify, YouTube, all that. Make sure you guys subscribe, follow us on Ace of Fates Barbershop and Tattoos, Polo Cuts SD, Manny Rocks with the Z at the end, Tat Knees. My boy Manny, what's your Instagram, big dog?
At sdfitservices.com.
There it is.
There you go.
Omatic made it in the back. We got my O-Matic. Brother-in-law and his girl in the back. Much love, y'all. See you guys next time, baby.
Good night. Thank you.
Peace.